Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So it's that time of the year again, it's Mermay, and although I will not be participating for the entire month of May, I thought that I should at least get one mermaid piece out there. So for those of you who don't know, Mermay is an art challenge where you draw a mer creature every day for the month of May. The fun thing about this challenge is that you can get to explore a different world entirely, and if you've never drawn mer creatures like me, this is a great opportunity to like step out of your comfort zone and draw something that you've never drawn before. And it just gets your imagination and creativity going, and yeah, you can just have fun with it and see what you can do with it. So for this piece, I got the inspiration while browsing some underwater fantasy world pictures on Pinterest. Lately, I've been very fascinated with these kind of pictures. While I was browsing through these pictures, I thought, so here is a reckless young mermaid who kind of wandered off and she stumbles upon this glowing treasure chest, and she is in the act of opening it, so who knows what's in there. I wanted the feel and the atmosphere of this piece to be kind of eerie and dark, so I drew skulls and bones and dead fish skeletons. So before I went ahead and drew everything out on my watercolor paper, I did some rough sketches in my sketchbook so that I could get an idea of where I wanted everything to go. I did 3 rough sketches in all, and you can do as many as you want. I think these kind of sketches really help you to get an idea of how you want the actual finished piece to look like. They're just really great for planning stuff ahead. Also, once I have an idea of where I want everything to go, I can just lay down the sketch on my watercolor paper, and because I have already decided on all my elements of the piece, I can minimize erasing on the watercolor paper as much as possible so that I don't damage the paper's surface. By the way, the references that I used for this illustration will be linked in my description box, as always. I always have a scrap piece of watercolor paper beside me to test my colors on, and if you're not sure about what colors you're using and how it's gonna look when it dries, I definitely recommend doing this, and it helps you to see how different colors will look next to each other, and it will also avoid muddy colors. The watercolor paper that I'm using is not 100% cotton. This one is 100% cellulose paper. And even though I haven't really used any other kind of watercolor paper, I've heard that if the paper is not 100% cotton, the layer will dry a little bit patchy because the paper is not very absorbent. And so when the paint dries, the pigments separate and it becomes patchy. So I used that patchiness to my advantage here to give a rocky texture to the pillars at the background, and I tried to make it work in my favor. However, the patchiness is avoidable if you work a little carefully and not let any excess wet paint puddles linger on the surface of the paper. But eventually it all comes down to practice, and a lot of practice will give you a feel of how you should work with your watercolors. But if you get patchiness in the first layer, you can always go in with successive layers and try to cover up some of the patchiness and try to get as even a wash as possible. And another thing to keep in mind is that when you work with watercolors and when you work in layers, if you don't let the previous layer dry completely and you go in with the second layer with a lot of water, you can potentially lift up the layer underneath and it might mix with the layer that you're currently laying down. And that might be useful in some cases if you want that to happen, but most of the time that will lead to even more patchiness. So when you go in with successive layers, you really need to have more pigment and less water on your brush so that you don't accidentally lift up the layer underneath. And then with the smallest brush that I own, I'm just going ahead and adding some line work And I'll also add some fun details in a minute, like turtles and fishes and the fish skeletons on the rocks. So for adding the highlights, I'm going in with my white brushstroke watercolor paint. The watercolors that I used are the Camel Artists watercolors, and the white that I'm using is from the brushstroke watercolor set. And it lays down quite opaque on these Camlin ones with enough layering. And so I added bubbles and some other highlights with the white paint. And I also lifted up some of the details that I added. I do this quite often. I think if I add this thing, it might look cool. And then I go in with a damp tissue paper and then I lift up the whatever I added. So I'm someone who uses a lot of lifting techniques in my watercolor process. And I'm finally done with my first ever watercolor illustration. This was a struggle, and that is an understatement. But I honestly had a lot of fun with this piece, and I think I learned a lot of stuff that I will be using in other illustrations. And yeah, I hope you like this video. Let me know in the comments if you are participating in Mermaid, and I hope you have a great day and a great week ahead of you. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you soon in the next one. Bye!